Hello and welcome back to Backspacer57's Minecraft channel and series. So, I've been reading a few of the comments on the last video, and first of all, I have not updated the channel very much. So, this video is kind of to address some of those questions, mostly regarding modifiers, and then a little bit more on redstone automation of Tinker's stuff, and then covering some of the new stuff in 1.10.2 Tinker's, especially as it pertains to the new Hermit Pack, which is out, and this is currently the Hermit Pack. So, first, let's go to the questions. So, people said, or two people commented on the channel, mostly saying, can I add more modifiers onto my tools? So this one, I pulled out of the menus. It has 5 modifiers available on it, initially. So say I want to add haste, I can add a whole bunch of redstone to it, and then that gives it haste, and that I used 2 modifiers for haste. So now I have 2 modifiers, or 3 modifiers remaining. Say I wanted to upgrade it so it can now mine steel, or at the steel level. So I can upgrade it to the iron mining level? Let's see here. Maybe this might not be the best one to do. Tool parts and cobalt, yeah. So let's go ahead here, slap that guy on. Oh, I guess we're not allowed to do that. Alright, so, whatever. Not allowed to do that one. However, I can slap a diamond on it. It'll upgrade it to diamond mining level, increase the durability, leave 2 minifiers left. I want to add in luck. I can go in here. I can throw in 60 luck. Now I have 1 modifier left. So luck 1, which means that I'll get nice things, according to the tooltip. Say I want to make it mending, so I put mending moss on it. And then that gives me no modifiers left. However, what can I do now? Well, I can slap another star on there, and then I'll soul bind it to me. That doesn't use a modifier at all. In older Tinker's Contract ones, you could use a golden apple and a block of diamond, or a single diamond and a block of gold. And those recipes have been taken out. Instead now, you have to go ahead and use one of these bonus tool modifiers. And that'll give you an extra modifier. And then you can load it up with even more, say, luck, or haste, or whatever it is. And to get to those modifiers, let's get out of that menu. Bonus modifiers. We can look at the recipes real fast. I'll turn that off. And that's basically the same exact recipes as they were before. Let me set that real fast. If we were to go ahead and grab ourselves a crafting table, or a crafting station, as it were, we can go throw that guy over there, chuck that in there, chuck that in there, bonus tool modifier, chuck that in there, give ourselves a golden apple, bonus tool modifier 2. Bonus 2 modifier 3 is still the nether star, but we have to add in some kind of head, and then that gives us bonus tool modifier 3. We can add up to 3 extra modifiers on a tool, so then that can give us several more levels on it. As you can see, that one doesn't work since I already have the first modifier level. I'd have to ask to add the second one, and then I could go ahead in here and put that emerald on, and I'd be able to get that. The emerald durability out, which would be pretty cool. Emerald increases the durability on the base stats. So that's kind of that, how to add more things on your modifier. Sorry if that seems a little bit confusing. The gist of it is, though, is that mending moss adds mending. To get to mending moss, I should probably cover that. Mending moss is crafted. Well, I think that's a dungeon drop, if I'm correct. You can also use a ball of moss, and a ball of moss will have the same effect. Emerald increases durability, as does diamond. Diamond makes it a diamond mining level. Emerald adds, I believe, 50% durability in the base stats, and diamond just adds like 500 durability. And then we have lapis for luck. Luck is like fortune. Redstone for haste, speed. Soulbound means that only you can use it and pick it up. Basically makes it only for you. And yeah, that about covers all of the modifiers. So, the things that I wanted to cover more in today's episode, new things in Tinkers. As you know, Tinkers has always had multiple ways the smeltery can be built. So the smeltery in the old versions could be built in a 7x7 base area. So that's pretty big when you think about it. 7x7, that's huge. Now it can be built 11x11, so that's even bigger. You can build it as tall as you want. So that means that you can have tons upon tons of slots, and I already have thousands of slots in this thing. And we can use glass blocks for the... Or we can use seared glass blocks for windows into our smeltery so we can see what it looks like when we're smelting things. But in the end of 1.7.10 and in the new Tinkers, we can also do this. As you can see, I just chucked an item in there and it pops up in there and starts smelting. So we don't even have to use the smeltery controller interface anymore, although we could put a hopper into it. And I could even demonstrate that. Grab a hopper. You could put a hopper into it. And I could go ahead and throw some cobalt in there. And I'll start smelting that cobalt right there. So I can get into that interface either through the top of the open top smeltery or through a hopper into that smeltery controller. This opens up new redstone automation to me. So I can then say load a dropper full of gold ore and hit a whole bunch of times, and then you can see I just add in as much ore as I need to, about as fast as I need to. So if I go ahead and I just dump, I don't know, say 19 of this. Whoops. I'm in creative, so that deletes it. If I go ahead and dump 6 of it in, it adds it instantaneously. So it's not as slow as adding a hopper in, and it so it's actually a little bit faster. I can also do this with a dispenser, if dispensers be your thing. Let's see, where is it going? Yeah, there you go. I can do it with a dispenser as well. So that dispenser adds in quite a bit of functionality. And so you can see my cobalt and my molten gold. Additionally, drains have 3 outputs on them. I think I mentioned this in the last one. So we can actually add in extra faucets on the edge here. Let me set that to day again. So we can have tanks all the way around our edges, which is actually pretty cool. Now, that is really, really useful for automation, but say we have a whole bunch of things that we need to get in here. Well, we can go ahead and we can use what's called a slime channel. And the slime channel can be reached by smelting a block of congealed Tinker's slime, which you can get on slime items, or slime items, slime islands. And then that'll give you these little dudes, and I can just grab a couple, just to kind of show you. And depending on the direction you're standing, they direct what way you flow, and they don't flow everywhere like water. So they're actually a lot more useful than water is, and they're all pretty uniform. We don't need to make use of the 8 block spread of water. We can actually just line these things up in a row and they'll just keep on going. It's pretty consistent. It's not exactly as fast as things traveling on ice, but it works really well. Now, say we have a big production and we have all sorts of items flowing into our smeltery. Well, there's a couple of things that we can add to the smeltery that don't necessarily come from ores. And one of those would be emeralds. Emeralds is probably the biggest thing that a minecrafter needs. And so we can go ahead and we can grab a whole bunch of villagers. And I can show you what I mean. Emeralds are super important in Minecraft. And an easy way to get it is to make a villager spawner above a smeltery and have the excess villagers flow into the smeltery. As long as there's some kind of liquid in the smeltery, they'll take damage and they'll become emeralds in the smeltery. So as you can see, we have a whole bunch of millibuckets, basically. Not too much. The reward is not wonderful, but it is something. So we can grab one of our casts, and say we want a single-use cast, we can use the new clay cast feature. It's a gear cast. Oh, well, clay casts don't come in gem size. So I believe we'll have to use... Where's the gem? I should have grabbed this before. Ah, gem cast. There we go. So we can go ahead, we can specify that we want our emerald out front. We can push some emerald in there, and it's going to need quite a bit more. So we can hit this one. Now, as you can see, I added in a few other mobs here. The zombie is spawning as a husk in the desert biome. And the creeper spawns as well. A poorly designed redstone over there. But they'll take damage, and they'll become blood. Now, blood is relevant as a material use, especially if we're going to make something like pig iron. You can use blood, you can get blood from pretty much any animal, and then you can also put pigs into smelteries, and they'll become pig guts, and you can mix it with iron, and you'll get pig iron. But yeah, that's a gist on what this is. Only thing is you can't get those drops, and you'll actually take damage if you come in here in survival, so with creeper drops, it won't really work out too well unless you have a minecart going underneath it. Good way of killing mobs, though, if you want to get blood and item drops if you have like a minecart underneath it with a hopper. Now, two additional structures that Tinkers has and introduces in 1.10 are that could help the automation of this smeltery is the tank controller, or the Tinker tank with a tank controller, and the Tinker Furnace, which is also known as the Seared Furnace. You need a furnace controller for this one, and a tank controller for this one, and then pretty much the exact same blocks as you need for the smeltery. For a tank, though, you don't need a seared tank. You can build it out of any block, pretty much. You just need a tank and at least one drain. The drain can go, I believe it's supposed to be able to go anywhere in the structure. That's what the description says. Let's see. Yep. The drain can go anywhere in the structure in the seared tank. And the tank absolutely requires a frame along all sides. So if I go ahead and I break this frame at any point, it gets disrupted inside. So a frame is that little extra bit that we don't have to have along these edges here. So that would be your frame. And that enables you to use a Tinker Tank. Now, a Tinker Tank stores a lot of fluid. This is 216 buckets. So if I could find a way to route that fluid into that smeltery, and you can do that. You can do that through a channel, you could do it through a faucet, and then you could have a faucet empty out into, say, the seared tank over here, so then you could stagger this Tinker tank to this corner here, have that tank positioned there, and then just empty that faucet right into that tank. That would work. And you could store just absolute enormous quantities of lava ready to go for your smeltery as you need it. If you're using a mod pack, such as Hermit Pack, you could actually hook this up to tubes and then have tubes pipe over your lava to that tank for you. You could also have this seared tank store multiple fluids. So as you see, I have some molten iron in here, some water, and you won't have cobblestone form. And I can just deposit things in here by bucket. So say if I'm trying to store a whole bunch of water for something, or a whole bunch of lava, or maybe I have some lava or some iron coming out of it, and I grab it out of that tank and throw it in here, or so on and so forth. It'll work out. So let's see. I could go ahead, grab an iron pickaxe, set this to daytime, toggle the game mode, grab you, and I could show you. What do I mean? Let's see here. No. Sorry about that. Alright, back to game mode. Right. So here, I think I can position you there. And you there. Huh. Let's see here. There we go. I can grab a whole bunch of stone. And I kind of removed that lower layer so I can definitely show you how everything works. And then so that deactivated. So then I can go ahead and I can put in, say, that guy. And then... Right. So toggle game mode, add it to creative, and you can see that my gold is flowing from that tank straight into that tinker tank. So I can even move tanks if I wanted to. So it's a really useful way of cleaning out a smeltery, storing a whole bunch of stuff here, and not worrying too much about lava storage, water storage, gold storage, iron storage, and things will not mix. Like water and lava. I don't know if your tin and your copper will mix. We could actually test that right now. I could, since I'm in cheat mode, I can just go grab some tin. Where would it be at? So we have a bucket of molten tin, copper, bucket of molten copper. So we could go ahead and throw some copper in there, throw some tin in there, and no, it's not going to mix into bronze. So you can actually store pretty much anything you want. It won't become an alloy. So yeah, you could have one massive tank, and that can store all your stuff. Now over to the Tinker's Furnace, or the Seared Furnace. This is basically a super useful way to get... a furnace structure into a really compact space. So you can actually, every spot inside is an individual furnace, and it smelts a little bit faster than a furnace. So we could actually grab a whole bunch of chicken. We could grab, say, 64 chicken. And we could go jam it all in there. And it should start smelting, or I think in theory it should. Oh, wait a minute. That's cooked chicken that I grabbed. I want the uncooked chicken. There you go. And it'll do it in blocks of 16 if you want, or it'll do it in blocks of 1. And so blocks of 16 will go slower, and blocks of 1 will go about a little bit faster than normal speed, and you can see it decreases. It uses lava to do this, so you can't use coal, but you know, if you have access to the Nether, you know, lava's not going to be an issue, so you can easily go ahead and use your tinker's tank here, store a whole bunch of lava, stock your smeltery and your furnace as you need it, smelt a whole bunch of chicken when you need it. And so you have an unlimited supply of easily cookable food and unlimited storage space for your smeltery. And you can even have an unlimited emerald supply if you're just dumping villagers into your smeltery. So, yeah, I think this video is a little bit faster. Let me know if it was just too much to go over in a 20-minute period, or if you'd like me to elaborate on any... one particular part. Yeah, I'm really excited to have some feedback from the community on this one, If you'd like to see more, please leave a like and definitely subscribe. And if you want to see a Let's Play, you know, of course, comment down below. But yeah, I love using Kinkers. It's an excellent mod pack, essential. And it adds a lot to the game, I think, and it's totally Minecraft themed. So I'm going to work on doing some more automation things. Maybe I'll do like a super smeltery, and I'll kind of show off a little bit, you know, how to make simple redstone additions to the vanilla smeltery, so to speak, of Tinkers. And yeah, so please leave a like, subscribe, and you'll stay in the loop for the next video. Thanks.